This is an older section of Sarajevo, as you see it from the top of the luge course on Mount Trebevich. There are mosques down there built when this land was ruled by the Turks centuries ago. Today, however, our attention is on a different sort of architecture, a building called the Start House. Here, the competitors wait their turns for the solitary plunge down the mountain. Sport of luge. It's still relatively unknown in the United States, where there are fewer than 300 participants, but it's very popular in East Germany, West Germany, Austria, Northern Italy, and most recently, it's become popular in the Soviet Union. Hi, I'm Sam Posey, and we're just moments to go now before the start of the men's singles competition. The format is very simple, really. Each competitor will make one run per day for 4 days, and the winner will be the man with the lowest elapsed time for those 4 runs. Working with me today as our expert on the sport of luging is Jeff Tucker. Jeff is a former national champion and was the highest placed American on the American luge team in the Winter Olympics in Lake Placid 4 years ago. Now, Jeff, the first man down the hill today is going to be an American, Frank Masley. And less than 24 hours ago, Frank was carrying the flag in the opening ceremonies for the Olympics. Obviously, an incredible moment for him. Now, as a former Olympian yourself, can you give us some idea what he must be going through as he tries to readjust from the excitement of that moment to what he has to do here?
Well, walking into an opening ceremonies as a member of the U.S. Olympic team is just an incredible experience. Carrying the flag, that's just fabulous. That's something Frank will carry with him for the rest of his life. What he's got to do now, though, is carry over the enthusiasm, the excitement, into this race, but he's also got to put some of that behind him. He's got to focus his attention and concentrate on the runs he has over 4 days. He's really got to apply himself.
Do you think he has any chance?
Well, Frank's done very well in international competition. He's risen through the ranks. He's had some good finishes. But as you know, the competition here is going to be between the very strong Russian team of Yuri Harchenko and Sergei Danilin and the Italians, Paul Hildegardner, Ernst Haspinger. It's going to be an exciting race. They've been neck and neck in training, trading off the fastest run. I think we're going to have a great race soon.
The face you see, Frank Masley, 4-time national luge champion in the United States, 6'1" tall, 185 pounds. He's from Newark, Delaware. You know, he's a true amateur and in every way embodies the spirit of the Olympics. And we had a chance to talk to him about a moment that was very special in his life yesterday when he carried the flag in the opening ceremony.
I never expected to have this honor to carry the flag. And my fellow athletes gave me the position to carry the flag, and it's a big day for luge, I think, also, the sport of luge. We've never carried the flag before, and my athletes put me in there. My fellow luge athletes picked me, and then the whole American team picked me, and I'm so happy, and I'm proud to be an American.
On the right of your screen with Frank Masley there, Sven Rumstad, the very young, just 23-year-old coach of the U.S. luge team. Frank Masley, obviously a very hot prospect for this year and for the Calgary Games beyond. Now, Frank had a personal best time down the run, Jeff, a couple of days ago. There's just 1 second off the track record set by Paul Hildegardner. So this could be very, very important. Of course, this is the moment he's waited for so long, trained for 4 years. There's been so much publicity, so much anticipation. Now he must put it on the line.
Well, that's right, Sam. It's showtime for Frank, and he knows that. He's a seasoned competitor. He seems to rise to the occasion. I think we're going to see a very good run from him. Of course, it's the first man down. We haven't seen anybody else yet come down, but great start for him, Sam. Very nice start for him. Right back into the position. Super aerodynamic position there. Head all the way back, toes pointed. Let's see, his first split's coming up.
All right, the upper part of the track. Very important before they really gather a lot of speed, not to make any mistakes, not to hit the walls at all, because you scrub off so much speed before you really build up that rush of energy later in the course. There's the first split time, 21.3. We'll be watching those as the competition develops. But Frank now coming onto the long straightaway where speeds of about 70 miles an hour will be hit here.
He looks great, Sam. He nailed this straightaway right down the middle. It's a tough turn 9 and into the labyrinth. It's a tricky section from the men's start.
There is a labyrinth turn, right, left, to right, and now he's out onto the last turn of the track, the finish turn.
It's a terrific run for him, Sam. A 46.89 with the snow on the track. That's really a fabulous run for Frank. He's got to be very pleased with that. It was clean all the way down. He drove good lines, maintained a good aerodynamic position.
You see Frank Masley there in the men's start house. He is boarding his sled now. Sven Rumstad, the American coach, with him there. Now, a big controversy, Jeff, has surrounded this run that Frank is about to make.
That's right. Even though today is the fourth run, Frank is taking his third run. He wasn't given adequate time to prepare at the start yesterday. The American team filed a protest, and after a lot of arguing, a lot of bickering, they won. And Frank's going to get two runs today, a chance to rerun his run yesterday.
Well, this is good. Now, I understand that the reason that he was able to file his protest was that they had not sent the four-runner sled down that's supposed to check out the timing, the conditioning of the course, and so forth. Now, to have two runs on one day like this, that, it strikes me, is a considerable advantage for Frank. This could be very good news.
I think Frank is probably pleased about this. Not only that, but the track is faster today, so his third run is going to be on a better track than yesterday. I hope he can play this to his advantage now.
Well, fascinating. Now, I'll tell you what I find particularly impressive about this is that our American coaching effort, Sven Rumstad and Bob Hughes, were able to make this happen. I mean, it's not easy to go through the procedures, the protests, filing everything. And not only did they do it, they showed considerable orderliness and made it happen.
They did a great job. They filed the protest. It was turned down. They appealed. It was turned down. They appealed again. It was turned down. And finally, they went to the president of the Luge Federation, and they won.
Right. Well, here's Frank Masley, in effect, given a second chance. Not that he had a bad run yesterday, Jeff. It just wasn't as good as it should have been, perhaps.
And he looks great right now, Sam. He's riding a beautiful line. The position's excellent. Seems like he's got a great run going.
All right. This is the first run of the day, and he will also be the last run of the day. Frank Masley, the American, working now the lower part of the track. Jeff, his form is beautiful.
And he's just got it nailed, Sam. Absolutely perfect labyrinth through the finish curve. He's going to be very happy with this time. A 46.797. That's about a second faster than the run he had yesterday.
Well, you see, and it moves him into 12th place at the end of three runs, where he was place, and he's moved up extremely dramatically, Jeff. This is fantastic. Frank Masley now 12.
You can see him smile. He knows he nailed that run. Very happy, but he's got one more to take.
Oh, that is fantastic. And I might say, sir, that this now means that Frank Masley, currently in 12th, is as highly placed as any American has ever been in the Luge competition, because you yourself at Lake Placid finished 12th.
That's correct, Sam.
All right, well, good luck to Frank Masley.
The standings after the final run in men's luge. The winner, Paul Hilgartner of Italy. This is the first gold medal won in these Olympics by an Italian. In second and third, two Soviets, Sergei Danilin, who fought back from a poor first run, and 20-year-old Valerie Duden. Frank Masley, who was given that controversial rerun earlier in the day, has finished 14th.